The procedures are sort of interventional procedures for chronic pain management, injections. We concentrate more on diagnostic part rather than treatment. So the importance of diagnostic injections is to figure out if the treatment, future treatment, may help or not. We used to do diagnostic injections with fluoroscopy, which is X-ray, and the problem with X-ray, or problems are many: radiation exposure, additional personnel, cost, and availability. So usually patients need to have several trips to the hospital in and out to have the procedure done with fluoroscopy. With ultrasound, we can do exactly the same procedure with the same quality, but just at the end of the appointment. So we did appointment, it's finished, have a treatment plan or diagnostic plan, and we do procedure right away. To our knowledge, we are the first academic center in the country. And just recently, I came back from Europe and had discussion with European group, ultrasound for chronic pain, people from Vienna and Bern. And according to all knowledge, we're only one center in Canada and the second center in USA. We started approximately the same time, Sunnybrook and Cleveland Clinic Foundation, and we do slightly different things, but the same area of chronic pain. Okay, we plan now the research of the major issue is standards of care. So if we want to change standards of care, we need to provide first-line evidence-based medicine, which means it's been for a while that we used to use fluoroscopy for diagnostic injection, for example, neck joint. Now, to convince medical community that we can do the diagnostic test with ultrasound, we should provide research. Predominantly, we seek spinal pain, meaning chronic low back, chronic neck pain. We seek shoulder pain, chronic shoulder pain, less, but it's more and more we see cancer pain. Okay. So cancer pain is another venue for ultrasound application for treatment. First of all, very obese patients. The current technology isn't perfect to penetrate into the depth.
Okay.
And patients with extremely degenerative changes of spine, I would prefer to use fluoroscopy as a standard rather than ultrasound. Because I cannot see the clear landscape of the bone under ultrasound when the degenerative changes are severe. And many people now are more and more interested in, we do workshops for doctors here, and in more global planning is to get together all groups from North America, Europe, and South Korea to discuss the education and research project of ultrasound and pain medicine. Another very interesting development is 3D ultrasound. So we know 3D ultrasound in gynecology, that we see baby and face and everything is nice. So now we do have technology for chronic pain management. It's coming, it's here, but we don't have still knowledge of technology and the picture. So one of the plan is to start to use 3D dimension ultrasound and actually to see the landscape and to see the path of the nerve and see the progress of the medicine around the nerve. So it will be very, very, very interesting. So the referral to our clinic is very simple as any other academic center, through family doctor or any referral doctor, orthopedic surgeon, neurologist, neurosurgeon. It goes through the process of selection. Because our clinic is predominantly interventional pain management facility, we cannot see all patients, but the patient that we see and select for specific procedures, we do these procedures with using different tools, including ultrasound. There's not much information, unfortunately, on the web regarding ultrasound. It's lots of information about ultrasound in regional anesthesia. not so much in pain. Still, you can find at the site usra.ca, ultrasound in regional anesthesia, with nice pictures of ultrasound imaging, mostly for regional anesthesia, some for pain. Okay. But at least to get the impression what does it mean to see nerve under ultrasound.